Hey guys, I am here with Liz Johnson today, and Liz is the president and principal consultant of Mountain View Marketing. Liz has an amazing 44 years of branding, marketing, advertising, and PR experience, and 19 years of website and social media experience. It's a lot of years of experience right there. Liz has built and leveraged a lot of engaging and effective brands and grown businesses of all sizes and different verticals throughout the United States. And with all that experience, I just wanted to bring Liz in today to give you guys a little taste of what makes a brand successful and really like what is your brand, because she is such an expert in this topic and to really just give you some tips and tricks on figuring this out. So, Liz, I'm excited to have you and hear what you have to tell us about this.
Oh, thank you, Carrington. It's a pleasure to be here today. First of all, it's important to know what makes a brand successful. A successful brand is three things. It's engaging, effective, and consistent. And consistency is key. When you present your brand consistently across all platforms, you can increase your revenue by up to 23%. It's a pretty significant jump. Businesses that brand consistently across all platforms, both online and offline, receive 3.5 times stronger brand visibility in the marketplace, which is also very important for your business. Statistically, it's important to remember that it takes 5 to 7 times for people to see your brand before they remember it.
So when you say consistent across all platforms, there's a lot of people out there who say pick your one or two platforms and just stick with that. So from your perspective, do you think it's more beneficial to be on multiple platforms across the board or really just hone in on one or two?
I think it's important to focus on the platforms where you're going to engage with your ideal target markets, both your primary and secondary target markets. And it's fine if it's just several channels. It's just really important that you're completely consistent on all of those channels you choose. Sometimes you'll see businesses that really don't do that as effectively. And when you don't brand consistently on all the platforms where you appear, there's a lost opportunity cost with that.
Yeah, no, that makes a lot of sense because I know a lot of brands get stressed out. They're like, I'm spread too thin. I can't be on TikTok and Instagram and LinkedIn and this or that. So is there any like tips or tricks to really figuring out like, all right, this is where I need to be and how I can be consistent to see that growth?
Well, first, you need to define your ideal target market, both your primary ideal target market and your secondary target market. And then you need to do the research and find out where you will engage with your primary and your secondary target market. And then that's where you need to be. That's where you need to build and leverage your brand. So, for a lot of B2B companies, for example, LinkedIn is your best channel and digital advertising. So, you want to make sure that you're investing, building, and leveraging your brand where you're really going to engage with your ideal target markets, both primary and secondary.
That's awesome. So when you are working with different brands, do you help them figure out who that primary and secondary is? Like, is there a process that you help people with?
Yes, there's very much a process. It's a very scientific process to actually analyze the value propositions that you have, the unique brand assets that you have, the target market segments that really need and are ready to purchase those brand assets and products and services, and then where you're going to engage with them. So it's definitely a research type project to determine your primary and secondary target markets. One of the biggest mistakes companies make is they don't create a secondary target market. And markets peak and ebb on different cycles. So it's to your best interest to have both a primary target market and a secondary target market, because then the dips in the market are less significant for your business.
That makes a lot of sense. So for people who are in a process where they're just trying to figure this out and they maybe don't have any clue on where to start, where would you tell them to start?
Well, all successful businesses, without exception, are value proposition driven. Your value propositions answer four questions. Why choose your company? What sets you apart from the competition? What unique assets do you provide to your clients? And what unique assets do you provide to the local and regional community? That's the giving back component. We track the analytics of absolutely everything to give our clients a competitive edge in the marketplace. And I can tell you that 5 years ago, giving back to the local and regional community carried a decision-making weight of 30%. Today, it's 80%.
Wow, that's a big jump.
People want to work with businesses that give back specifically to their local and regional community. You want to make sure you weave the answers to those four questions visually and verbally into your branding and all of your outreach. And that requires top quality professional branding photos and results-driven outreach text.
Awesome. Those are some really great tips and questions for people to think about. If anyone isn't really sure where to get started and they want to chat with you about it, what's the best way for them to get in touch with you?
I would welcome the opportunity. I'm happy to do a complimentary consultation with anyone who's interested, and they can reach me at liz@mountainviewmarketingllc.com or connect with me on LinkedIn and send me a message there. But I would welcome the opportunity. There's a lot of science behind successful branding, and we've helped businesses grow between 28% and 300% through branding.
That's awesome. Well, thank you so much, Liz. I hope people get a little bit out of this and start answering those questions. And I can't wait to chat again in the future.
Thanks so much, Carrington. It's been great to be here. Thank you.
Bye.